Hey guys, what's up? It's Christine Seal, the High Level Queen, and today I am going to show you how to create high level workflows from existing campaigns so that you don't need to copy and paste your SMS and your emails anymore. So let's get started. So for those of you guys who don't know, we actually have a free Facebook group called Marketing Agency Automation Secrets, where we give away hundreds of dollars in free trainings every single week to our members. So click the link below to go check that out. Okay, so we are going to do this in just five easy steps. And the first thing that you're going to want to do is choose your campaign that you want to convert to workflow. So just open it up. So I'm going to do my affiliate here. And then I'm going to open up workflows in a new tab so I can go back and forth. I also need to know what my trigger is for this as well. So you're going to want to open the campaign and the trigger first. And this is because we're actually going to combine the two in one workflow, okay? So I've got the trigger and I've got the campaign. Now I'm going to open workflows and I'm going to say create workflow. Now here you can either start from scratch or do any of this, but I'm actually going to choose a campaign because I don't want to have to redo, like copy and paste everything. So I'm going to choose my campaign and then click the green button. Okay, now I talk about this in another video, but this is basically in a nutshell just saying that anything in the campaign configuration is not going to pull through into the workflow. So if you're using any of these things, you need to actually build them into your actions or into your global settings in your workflow. So it pulled in all of my emails from my campaign here, okay? Which is cool. So now I need to do my trigger. Well, the campaign part's done. So I'm in my trigger, and basically how this maps out is what's on the left is actually now on the top. And what's on the right in the trigger is actually now at the bottom. So I have my triggers and my actions instead of my triggers and my actions. Hopefully that makes sense. So you just flip it like this, okay? So I need to add my trigger. And you can see that I am doing a contact tag trial here. So I'm going to do a contact tag is trial like that, and I'm going to hit save. But now the cool thing is where I used to have multiple triggers for one campaign or multiple triggers and multiple campaigns, I can now have multiple triggers with one campaign in one workflow. So instead of all of this mess where I've got hundreds of triggers and hundreds of campaigns, I can have one workflow to rule them all. Okay, guys? So I've got my workflow trigger set up. Again, I can add as many as I want in here, but I'm not going to do that right now. You can see that my emails have been imported, which is cool. My weight, so you can like rename these if you want. If you want it to be pretty, etc. Okay. Got the emails pulled in here. Okay. So all you have to do now is test your workflow. Okay. So we created the workflow from the campaign. We opened the old trigger. We mapped the steps and now we're testing. So you just type in your name here. You click on run test. I'm going to save that. I'm testing it. So if I refresh, Don't forget to click save, because if you refresh and don't click save, you're gonna be sad. So you can see here that I am now entered into this wait one day. If I go check my email, I should have an email accordingly. And then what you can do if you want to push it through is you can click on the running man and click move all. So that's just like the old times. Okay. So if I refresh it again, I should be able to see that I moved a step. So now I should have two emails. Okay. So if you're happy with your test, we're not done yet, because step five, you got to turn off your old triggers in your campaigns. So turn your campaign into draft mode in your, I'm sorry, this is my trigger. Trigger in draft mode and your campaign in draft mode, just to be like double safe, because what you don't want to do is send everything twice, okay? So turn off your old triggers and campaigns, and then you're going to want to test again. So for example, this is my contact tag. So now if I turn this to publish and then I go add a contact tag to a contact, it should add them to the workflow. So like if you go into your contacts, you add a tag here, then it should say workflow here like that. That's how you know it's working, okay? So you're gonna test again and make sure that, you know, you're not getting everything twice. Now I'm gonna go through the settings real quick, because I said that if you guys were using campaigns, that none of the campaign settings were gonna come through into the workflow, which is true. So this is actually here where you set the time window. Okay, so if you want to restrict the message to the time window, you're going to choose that. Okay, now this is kind of new. You can put your default email and name in here. So thank God you don't have to do it in each email anymore. You used to have to do that, which was a total pain. You can allow multiple, which means that, you know, you can put someone in more than once. Stop on response, same thing. If they respond, it's going to stop. Auto mark is red. So automated messages don't mark conversations as red. Toggle this on if you want the conversation that this workflow will interact with to be marked as red. And then if you are running an event, you're going to want to put the time, date and time in here. If you're doing appointment reminders, I have another video on how to do that, but you don't have to use this for appointment reminders, okay? You can also go into the history and see all of the times that the workflow has run, and then you can go to status and look at that as well. So that is how you create a high-level workflow from a campaign. I hope this helps you guys to get to know workflows better and for them to be less scary, okay? So don't forget to like and subscribe so you don't miss any future videos from me, and I'll see you next time.